Now I will introduce the everything I have learned in the past 3 days.
We're only in 7 minutes or less.
Okay. The first is I will introduce the Linux environment using the command language to perform simple and complex actions with just write a order encoded. If you want to insert text, you just press I and in the environment. If you save the file being edited, just press the ESC button and then type the letters. And if you want to quit the VI editor, just first press the ESC button and then type. And the last press the enter button. if you want to get the GTSPP data, I just show the method. One way to get the GTSPP data to use the web browser, you must type the website address here, and it's in the NODC Nova website. And then, if this website appears, you must move the mouse to the left and press the access GTSPP data, and then this window will show up. There are three ways to get the GTSPP data. One is the user defined. When the other is the real-time data set, and the three is the best copy data set. Mostly, we use the user-defined data set to get the GTSPP data. The second window, you can specify the time, the location, and the platform, and the shapes, and other all you want to specify. In the third window, you just press the submit button, and the result will show. And you just press this submit button, and you get the data file in your computer. Download in your computer. Until now, all I know is there are 26 text. Method to quality control GTSPP data. All they are introduced by our team, by Bob. I will not introduce in details. All the 26 tests just by are divided by five stages to quality control the GTSPP data. First is the location and identification test. The stage two is the profile test. And the stage three is the climatology test. And the stage four is the profile consistency test. And stage five is the visual inspection. After you quality control all the GTSPP data, you must flag the data to show the data is bad, is good or bad. The quality flagging level is the quality. The QC flagging scheme is divided two level. The first level, you just test the test number that indicate which test has been employed is attached to the every profile. Each test is assigned an index number to base two. The number that describes the suite of tests employed against the profile is the sum of the index number and is then written in the base 16. This is the example of how to quality flag. Now I will demonstrate how to load a netcdf file to the Ocean Data View. First, you must double the Ocean Data View and open this window. Then you just press the file, the menu, and open an NC file and press the open button. then this window appears. The left corner window is the location of this file, and all the other windows show the profile, such as the temperature and salinity, and depths. If you want to display the T and temperature and salinity diagram, you must move the mouse to one of the figure and press the right button of the mouse, and set. You can see this window. If you want to show the TS diagram, you must set the X variable be temperature or salinity, and the Y variable must be temperature salinity. This figure is the T temperature and the salinity diagram and of this station. All the others and the other such as depths and the depths and temperature profile, and this is the depths and the salinity profile. Thank you for your attention.
Any question, comment, opinion?
No question.
I have to score her. I'm not going to give her 100 points. I will give you maybe 95 only. Now, the way to describe the indexing is not quite right. Okay, and he didn't understood correctly. But after that, just before her presentation, who will present a check. So I think right now she should understand how to do the calculated QC test.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
So who will miss?
But well, yeah, it's a bit pointless because we're all gonna follow the same structure. So the first thing we do on the first day is learn how to use the Xmin, which mimics the Linux environment. And we use it to play with different commands, and we use the VI editor to modify these commands, etc. So I put a little demonstration of what we did on session 2 and 11 together. So we took an R script and we opened it with a VI editor to modify it and to point to a different data file. So first, I checked which files were under my data directory to choose one. Then I open it with the VI editor, and I don't know if you can see or not, but you have to change that thing that's highlighted in red and make it point to another file. And so for that, you use one of the tools we learned, the I for insert, etc. And you just type the other file name, and you run it, and you can even tell them to name the output with a different name. In terms of the quality control, there are different tests that are applied in different stages. So the first stage is more related to some metadata, like the platform identification, the date and time, location, and so on. Then we go to the actual profile values, and then some climatology tests. So what you do really is to check if the value that is found in the data falls within some ranges that are predefined, and if not, it is flagged. And some key things that we learn is that it's better not to change the data unless you're very sure that, for example, it's a negative coordinate or something like that. And even if you do, you have to keep the original value. We also learned that even if the automatic tests can flag some values as wrong, that doesn't mean that it's wrong necessarily. So that you need to be you need to be cautious about that. And then that we've got a lot of resources out there and different software and guides to help us doing the quality flag checking. And in terms of the flagging systems, what I understood is that there are two levels. In the first one, we look at how many tests have been performed and which ones. And to do that, each test has a base 2 number. So the total number of tests is the addition of these numbers, and then that is transformed to base 16, and that tells us how many tests has been performed and which ones. And because it is very unproductive to attach a flag to every test for every observation, which is give an overall quality flag to the whole observation and to the whole profile, and that indicates the overall quality of the data and according to those codes in the table. We also learn how to get GTSPP data either from with wget utility or with a web browser. So using the wget, we just went to the Linux environment and you just type wget, and you point to the HTTP or the FTP address. And in this case, I download the data from November 1999, but you can also download entire directories. And then we learn how to uncompress the data with some commands. With a web browser, you just go to that address and go to the user-defined datasets. You can define your or specify your spatial range. Sorry, but I don't think you can see the squares in the Mediterranean Sea, but there we are. You choose the data. In my case, I downloaded May from this year. You choose the data type, data mode, and download it. And then to display it in ODV, you first have to convert it to the ODV spreadsheet format using one script that it was provided. So you just run, well, you just go into the script and change the target file, and the you give a name to the output file. So it should appear in your folder, the new text file over here. And then you just go to ODV and import ODV spreadsheet, and there it is. And then we learn how to play around with the different displaying modes, how to change the different variables on the axis, or even to add a third dimension with a coloring system, and so on. And that's it.
Excellent. Any questions for her? Okay. I'm not going to score you, otherwise we will fight. Okay. Should we try for the third one, this one? Do you want to stop here for break? Number three?
Hi, everybody. I will, would like to talk about what is I learned 3 day. And the first I can talk about the work with in Linux software. The first we open the software Linux, and then when you want to edit the file, for example, that's t follow user and then type vi, and when you're into the page, you can type save key for insert tag, and save out, continue insert tag to next line, and locate D for delete, and locate U for undo, and control U go up, and control D go down, and then and I'm going to save key, I can type column H for save and exit file, and then you will come back to the go out the page. We quit by type column Q escape command. Yeah.
Okay, let me count it.
It's coming.
It's just shift I, it's just I. It's just shift uppercase I. That will be insert at the beginning of the line. So just it should be lowercase I. And it should be lowercase O. So not shift O, just O. Okay.
Just,
and
just
the number three is my fault. It should delete all X, small X. Not the D, that's my fault. The real life, I should say X.
Yeah, okay. I will check in. And then we want to get data from opening source. Source we can access to follow the website. The first one is a, it is, and yeah, like this. it's very difficult for me to for you to see. And then we can choose this area for guest get data to long T or late T, and then you will check the data available in area, and then we submit, and then we come back to prepare for, I don't remember. And then we submit, we get lost the file of data of this this area we choose. And another data we can get from website the right, and for lots of file into the R, we can open the R and the chain the file when you load about in the GTSPP for own folder, and then the map over there is so my lost that I lost data my area. It is near the South China Sea, near Vietnam, and then it is this area so data from 2013 and 2014 its area, and we can look here and can guess many data from each station in here, and then we can show it the salinity and temperature and depth in on one diagram, and easy to show, make you inside what how is the data. So for example, by using chains X scale, Y scale, and Z scale, that's okay. And I think it's we can explore the many kinds of data from ODV, Ocean DV, by creating many in the menu we can choose. And then maybe you can detail one transit. You can click on the map and click here for one transit. You can see the sum of station in only transit and show the depth and temperature and depth salinity, and it's a right area. It mean no data here, and the here it mean the converse of concentration, high temperature, or and then its depth, its survey, and the depth 1,200, and this is contour line, or easy to see the concentration here.
That's another describe the data you get from the internet. And thank you so much. It is what I can learn.
Okay, good. Question for her.
Can you go back to your section slide? So that very warm temperature spot on the left-hand side, what is that? Is that a signature of some sort of current?
Yeah.
Yes, that one right there. It's quite an unusual feature. That's
I had the same question too. So, So the lower point is
it's presumably down to the
so
south.
This point is here, is one here, transit.
Yeah.
Okay. I kind of really interesting if this is true, or maybe something wrong with the data.
Well, that's the question.
Or maybe
yeah.
We don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah. But that's
guess,
really interesting.
I guess that part is the Vietnam jets.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I'm not sure about the subsurface features. But that around 110, slightly around
yep.
10 degrees north.
Yep.
So that's where
yeah.
the Vietnam jets.
Okay. Okay. Now I was thinking it. Hoping it was a real feature and not just something bad in the data. But okay, interesting.
That's really impressive.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, okay, excellent.
Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you so much.
Okay.
I gonna present the synthesis of what we have done in these 4 days. For the training course of GTSPP. I remind you that I didn't put all things that we have on this course, but I do just the synthesis. For the Linux text editor. We can say what is VIP. VIP is an interactive text editor which is displayed oriented. It has two modes of operation, command mode and an insert mode. I present here an example that we use with VI. And for inserting text, we use the letters I, O, O, and to exit the insert text, we can use the command ESC. To save file, we use ESC with shift and column. And to exit VI, we have two possibilities to exit without. Without saving, and it is the second case, and we can also exit after saving, and we use the first case here. Yeah, to get some data from the GTSPP, we can go to the GTSPP web interface, which is mentioned here, and we follow the steps, which are specify the special range, the date specify the date, specify the data types, the products, and to submit the request, our request. With Linux. To go to get a file from the web, we can use the command wget, which is a free utility for interactive download, and it can support the HTTP, HTTPS, FTP. Before using it, we can use help. For having more information of how to use this command, and here I present you an example that we have used with the command wget. About the GTSPP quality control and flagging system. We present 5 types of QC tests, which are location and identification tests. This test is based generally on the identification of the location to look on the date or time and other things like that. There is also the profiles test, which use the which is related to parameters value, the climatology test, which is based generally in a range, which we look if the value we have or the profile we have is in this range or not. The profile constancy test use generally similarity of an of salinity or temperature observation with an value which is a threshold value which is fixed. For the flooding system, the basic principle is that each test is assigned an index number to base 2. And the process is that we must calculate the sum of the first indexing number of the selected test. Then we convert the 10 basis number to the base 16. And the resultant value of the sum with the index 16 gives the test number. We present here also an example that we used in the training. About loading net CDF file to ODV and TS diagram profile, we can download GTSPP data from this this link, and the next step is to copy the file in our working directory. The working directory we used here was gtraining, and then we convert the file in ODV. And in the ODV windows, it is that we present here below, we select a specific area with the option view, then zoom, and we make a plot with the view, then layout templates and scatter windows 102. And for the TS diagram file, we do a right click in the graphic and select the variables. Here I present some of the results after following these steps. And in a selected area. And for talking just about some results, we look here that we are in a situation in the Atlantics, which present salinities around 35, and the temperature are also low. Yes, to finish, I present a picture of the IOC office building. And if there are questions, you're welcome. Thank you.
I have a question for you.
Mm-hmm.
Can you show the slide for the VI? Yeah, okay. This one.
Yeah.
Okay. Does anybody know how he generates the graphic here? You see the number on the first column, 1, 4, 3, and so forth. Okay. He ran into a problem or something that he had to do, and he cannot get what he expect. So he called me. So I walk over and show him something. Okay. You know, in the Linux command, in the Linux system, there's a command called history, H-I-S-T-O-R-Y. When you say history, enter, they will give you the up to the length of your screen, which will show you the command that you used before. So that's why he got this repeat, show what he did in the past. But I'd like to come your attention. This is where he got a problem. First of all, he said, double get FTP, which is download. This is the the real-time file in ODV format. Now he tried to use a tar to extract
this file, which is a parent file, it's not a tuple.
Yeah.
Okay, nothing.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's why he got stuck. So he called me, so I explained to him.
Mm-hmm.
So I just kind of let you know. Okay. The other is why, later on he tried to do it to Kusen. Okay, good.
Okay, thank you.
I have a question.
Sure.
Yeah.
Go back to your last slide, before the picture, I mean.
Okay.
No,
yeah,
right.
Here.
On the far right, the
yeah.
TS diagram,
yeah.
There's two distinct sort of sets of data.
Mm-hmm.
The one that's on the right,
mm-hmm.
that is, I guess, more surface waters. Yeah, that sort of grouping on the right of the
yeah.
diagram.
Mm-hmm.
Where in the map,
mm-hmm.
where do you find those stations? Do you notice? Or is that, are those Mediterranean?
No, it is the Atlantic.
Right,
West.
But there are some spots in the Mediterranean, too.
Yeah, here.
Yeah, yeah.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah.
So presumably those are from the Mediterranean mm-hmm. basin.
So this is another question for ODB. You can zoom
mm-hmm.
to the area because what he did, it's a really large area. It's
right.
almost entire Atlantic Ocean
right.
and the cover some kind of Mediterranean.
Right.
So he zoomed into this area. Unfortunately, it covered this part.
Right.
Okay. But if you keep carefully going into this only, and I said this is where the water came from
mm-hmm.
for this part.
Right.
Yeah.
But this is very interesting.
Yeah.
See the two different water columns.
Right.
Water mess.
Exactly, yeah. And I hadn't noticed the spots in the Mediterranean or I wouldn't have asked the question.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Excellent. Any more questions?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Okay, so number five.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. First, I would like to thank the organizer of Ocean Teachers, probably Claudia and his team for organizing such a good training. And also our, I could say lecturers, that you know, have teach us a very interesting topics on GTSPP. Just to give some overview of my thoughts on the training, it's really interesting. I know that there's lots of equipment in the ocean, you know, collecting data throughout times, and lots of them. But before I came to the training, I never thought that that data has actually have a one data center that actually organize all of them, and then not only organize all of them, but actually, you know, you can use them. So there's two main things that actually impressed me about the training. One is you know, the vast amount of ocean data that available for you to use, and it's like, you know, I can imagine that, you know, you go to the fish market, and then you have all of these fish coming from all over the world that you can select. I mean if in the real case, if you go to the fish market in Belgium, basically you get fish from you know, North Sea or, you know, closer area. But I mean, in this case, you being tell that, you know, choose whatever you want, it's come from all over the world, and not only for the particular time, but you get back to like 1980s to that kind of data. That's one thing. And the second one is I've used some of the data, I mean, like Argo and some of the Drifter data before, but probably it's out of my ignorance that I never thought that you have such a very comprehensive quality control features in that kind of data. So that really impressed me then, and now at least I can show that, because we do our quality control manually, you know, looking for the spikes and things like that. But then after we've been presented with the quality control, now I realize that in all the headings of or the metadata, basically, you can get the information on the quality control that have been made. So at least it make, you know, you can save more times when you look at those data. I learned lots of things. Most of them is not new to me, but I remember that, you know, long time ago I've learned some of it. You know, Linux. I never do R, but ODV is quite familiar. But, you know, when you don't use it, basically you don't really, you know, get you need some time to get used to it again. So I mean, it's wonderful to get back and to look at ODV in a much more real perspective of plotting the GTSPP data, which is just wonderful. I know we have some data sets that being shown by our friends, which is, you know, just amazing looking at the, you know, once you get, I think it's once you know how to do it, basically you can do it in less than half an hour, you know, get the data, plot it, and you can see already this interesting features that you get from the places that you get. Just an overview of what we learned from Linux VI editor. So, you know, plotting get to edit some files from VI editor. You know, just get the VI and the file name, then you get things going on your I'm using PuTTY. So basically, I guess that Vim, X, Ming, and PuTTY is like a software that give you interface of Linux in your PC. So I think that this is much easier for me because, you know, I need to for X, Ming, it takes you a while because you need to key in all those information and then after you've done it, so when it's crashed and then you lost it and then you need to key in again, so it takes a while. So I mean, so that's why the background is black. And it is interesting using this black background because, you know, it's like, you know, you are like a computer guy, you know. So so that's what I mean, most of our impression, you know, when you have this black background and then like white text, you know, it's like, oh, this guy is this must be good with computers. So I always have that kind of impression. So I mean, it's good to work with a black background. So basically, I mean, most of us have shown that. I can skip that. So where to get GTSPP data? First, we tried that NODC website, which is wonderful because you can see that atlas or map of the global map that you can actually choose in a particular area. And like what Charles said, that it's also interesting because he extend that global atlas to, you know, another so you get to see the whole atlas ocean. And also you have another option of using the, I think this is actually you should be proud because I remember that Charles keep saying that we are the first group that you know, taking data from that new, is that new website for NODC. So so it is interesting as well because I mean, this set of data you use, you get, you know, whole chunk of it, but for that NODC's websites, you get to choose a particular site. But I guess that in the future, that features basically will be in the the website.
I think
well,
the left hand side will be made a set.
Okay.
It's a global data set.
Global data set.
So that by months and then by week. But that, what I will do is to improve the web interface.
Okay.
Replace the Java iPad by open layer.
So you can open it and then choose the set, make a selection. So that's why I put on top where it is interesting working with that because you can choose your specific site and also date and particular period. GTSPP data quality control, which impressed me. I reckon that looking at the five stages, it is very comprehensive. So, you know, at the first stage, you already identify the platform, looking whether it's in the right time or right place with the right speed. And then on the second stage is what we usually do. Manually looking at the spike, you know, whether it's right depth or not, looking at the profile and density. But I guess that when I do manually, I never done the remaining stage, the climatology test, profile consistency test. I mean, this is the thing that we don't actually do, you know, for my work before, but which is interesting that you compare it with the climate because. It gives you more insight to the data, whether it's right or wrong. So, and last, visual inspection, which is also interesting because you can really see the track, let's say, I mean, for a ship, you can see a cruise track, whether it's right or wrong. All right, this is some of the ODV data sets that I took from Center of South China Sea. Our friend from Vietnam showed earlier, it is very hard to get data within South China Sea, even from the GTSPP. But if you're lucky, in particular years, you get lots of them within the South China Sea. So this is during, I think, 2013 to 2014, for 1 year. From the data sets we've been discussing, I've discussed with Bob yesterday, most of data probably came from XBT equipment, because you can see there's lots of a temperature profile, but basically you have only a few salinity profile. Actually, when we go to that particular profile, it's actually coming from this particular cruise, probably a, I don't know, maybe a buoy, or maybe a scientific cruise. So I mean, that's what interesting about ODV. You can see directly what kind of data sets that you have. So in this case, you have a temperature and salinity, and so I did some cross section through that. I'm sorry. Okay, over there. So just do a nice cross section and get this. Not very. There's nothing striking that you can show, but what I can tell you is, I have actually one a published paper with one of my colleagues on water mass characteristic on the northern, along the coast of northern Borneo, which is over here. So I've plotted that, which I think data from Argo. And that is the data set that we get from our CTD, from our cruisers. So if you look at up to that 400 meters, basically we have almost similar trend of temperature profile when you compare with the one that we get from the GTSPP, which is kind of interesting. So I think that's all. So from the picture, it shows that we are very happy, you know, having a nice weather in Ostend, and you know, spending 1 week here. So thank you very much.
Excellent, really good. Okay.
I'm almost always asking things. Can you show your last slide before your last? One before that.
Yep, that one.
No, next one.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, so I wanted to, if you look at the temperature depth composite slides, you can see there's one station that has a big spike at around.
Oh, yeah, over there?
I think there's a way within ODV to say just plot the data with flag equals one.
Mm-hmm.
And if you do that, that should go away.
Oh, okay.
So that might be something when you're doing your...
Same like this one. I mean, if you think
that's
wrong, so you can just click that and then...
So I think you can, if you clicked on it, you probably would see flags of four on it, but I think you can filter by that too.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a division criteria.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah, so that would be something to think about, so you're not destroying everything that's come in as opposed to everything that's good.
Yep, thank you. So...
Okay,
thanks.
Wow.
Yeah. You know, yesterday, Ashar told us, if you don't do your presentation, you're not going. And I guess I had only 3 hours sleep. I was looking for the sleep never came again. But I was able to do something. Yeah, because we have said so much about the VI, but I just want to show a little. We'll explain what VI is for. It used to access text files in a Linux environment. And at the command prompt, when you type, say, example, my name, this comes up. The editor comes up, becomes active, and I said this is a practical class for using Linux environment in this place and some other things. So this the I which we have there will help us in certain text and every other thing. The O, the lower case O will make you to come after the cursor prompt. Maybe you are here, so if you type O under lowercase, it will bring you this way. And the uppercase line will bring you, the uppercase will bring you before the cursor prompt. Then these are the things we've talked about, some of us, my colleagues have talked about them. It's all about moving about there. Now, for us to save, we have that at the command prompt. You save your file name. And I think another thing is that you can also see the line where you are and the column. That's another thing about this. Yeah. Getting the GTSPP data. Looking at two areas here, through the web, the HTT stuff, was able to get some data from this, and also using the wget. So I had to like, on the command prompt there. So with this, we can easily extract directly to the folder where you want the data to be stored. And after the processing, 100%, it will bring you back to the prompt. The control tests and the flagging systems. We have 5 stages, and each of those stages has some sub stages under them. The location identification, profiling, climatology, profile consistency, and visual inspection. Why? The flagging system, I really didn't want to flog my so much on the level 1 or level 2, but I'm like, looking at these codes, this code indicates this information on each of the, it's used to identify what this is representing when there's a, flagging as regards the QC test. Yeah, this, I try to download the data from the NODC website. Then my data, I used user-defined data set for a month, just June, the beginning of June to 24th. And I took my range between 20 north, minus 9 south, 20 west, and 22 east. And I choose the best copy. And I have 106 stations. And then I downloaded. After the download, I had to modify my GTSPP to ODV to the file I want to convert or transform to ODB readable format. Then in my R, I was able to do that. Then I launched the ODV, imported the file, and then went to view to choose the kind of layer template I needed and followed every other information. Yeah, this was the way it was. So I choose within the Gulf of Guinea, a little into the Atlantic. These are the individual parameters. And when I overlay the temperature and the salinity, and that is the presentation for this. This is for the individuals, and that is for both. Then, I guess finally, I did a transect for these individual stations, and that is what we have there. Yeah. I have been hearing about AGO, but at least something I'm going out from here is I've been able to see a prototype of an AGO. I hope I'll be able to come into a program for AGO to be able to get it. But at least I appreciated my being here. If I'm not taking anything home, I'm taking that home. So thank you, everybody, for listening.
Question.
Many questions.
basically, again, looking at the data. So, do you guess? Do you know what? Probably, like there's two different kind of water mass. You see, there's two distinct features. So, probably you know any prior knowledge. Why you have a very different
types of PS? Is it this and that?
No, the
upper one.
Over here? Yeah, between that one and left and right one.
Okay, and this and that?
Yeah.
I'm looking at, I can't say specifically, but
never mind, just
wondering. Sorry?
It's kind of interesting.
Okay.
To me, it's very interesting because there are kind of three curves, three areas. This is the one big area.
Yeah.
And this is kind of unique because most of the surface, this is most of the surface data. And this look like very interesting. This is quite different. And the area is all not too far away. So this is a question mark. And this curve could be just a spike.
It looks like it's the wrong, that kind of a TS diagram is kind of what we see in the Northwest Atlantic off of Canada. No, the lower one. Yeah, it looks like it's in the wrong place. I don't know. It'd be interesting, right? And you see it on the temperature as well. It's that curve there, right on the far left.
This.
Yeah.
That too.
It looks to me.
That's the one that.
It looks to me like it's. My guess would be that it's not actually in that location, where it's stated.
Yeah.
That it's somewhere else. It really comes. Like I say, that looks like water that we see off of Labrador or Newfoundland. That's what it looks like. Because look at the temperatures. It's zero. You don't get 0 degree water at the surface in the equator.
So far we have six presentations. Each everyone gave a TS diagram plot.
Yeah.
And the six plots quite completely different.
Yeah.
But different ocean.
And then also everyone has some more or less some issue associated with the very funny, you know, curve. This is something that GTSPP do need. We need some kind of feedback from you. You see something, look at that, this one, that one, too, right? So send the DBID with the figure to us, so we can look into what's wrong with the data set. If there's as far as the cookie possession is wrong and the predicate is good, okay, and then so forth. So this is the feedback we need from user. Okay, excellent. Good. Thank you. Okay, so number
67. Good afternoon. This is my overview about the what we learn, the general about the data, and then also how to getting data, and then how the software we are using, Linux, ODV, R, how to can get the good data with quality control, and also there are any NC bros, and also many exercise. Yep. This is for the text editor on Linux. We are, for example, I'm using the text.txt, and we are using V. And then this is like the command. When we want to insert text, we are using uppercase I, and then if we want to write, edit, save, this one, column with W, and quiet V editor without saving is column Q exclamation. For getting the GTSPP data, we can two way to download using the access to GTSPP data, and also for the interesting location. For using Widget, Widget is a free utility for non-interactive download. We are, for example, for the using FTP, Widget option, where I'll, and then this one my FTP, and this one on Linux, and then after that, uncompress using tar.xzf, the name of file. For quality and flagging system on GTSPP data, there are 26 lists to do on QC, including indexing number, and divided to 5 stage. There are location and identification, profile, climatology, profile consistency, and visual. And also for the flagging system, there are 2 level, a test number that indicate which test have been employed, it is attached to every profile, and then index number to base 2, and then after that, sum up the index number, and is written in base 16. And for the level 2, indicate the quality of data. They are Arabic number 0 through 5 and 9. We are for the quality control and flagging system using the software and Quest and QCAid. For ocean data view, this is my area of interest between 93 east until 160, and also 7 until 6 until 16, I think. I'm wrong. This is perioded maybe only 1 month, less than 1 month, and with the number station only 100. This is the distribution of the salinity. We can see that the salinity in the surface layer, they are very low than in the deeper. And then for temperature, there is, I think it is same profile all of the number data. There is in the surface, and then thermocline under the same with the temperature. There is for the water mass, this is the isopic now with the same density, and we can see that there is any kind of two water mass in south of the Java. I think this is this one and this one. I think from the Indonesia is influenced by Indonesian trout flow from Ombay Sea and also from Lombok Sea, and in southwest monsoon there is very very from here, and there are South Java current, and from here influenced by the Indian Ocean. So there is, I think there is two kind of the water mass. This one, you can see in the profile section. This one, we can see in the west of the Sumatra, there is the salinity is higher than in the east of the Java, because there is many river, and then go up to this one, so the salinity is more lower than in here. And also this is the temperature. I think there is some in the blue color, we can see this is the influence by I think maybe South Java current go from here to here, and there is, and then go to here. Thank you and terima kasih.
Yeah. And then one more thing. That's good. Any question for him? No, but by sitting here and listening to different people, different presentation, I have one suggestion to all of you. How many of you go to ATU meeting? I was thinking maybe someone can hold a sixth section or AGU, one section. And the title will be something like using GTPP data in your region. And that would be interesting, because you can see, you can understand the global ocean at one place, one time. Different area has a different feature. Look at that guy, he pointed out the fresh water coming from that area, and it got the low salinity and the different criteria. That's kind of very interesting. So this is my suggestion, you know, if someone like to host a section in AGU, just say using GTPP data, be great. Okay, thank you.
Good afternoon. I am the line to be part for this course, GTSPP training. The first, they describe the feature of the Linux text. This is common for the Linux in Windows. It is the CD in KDEr. For I want this command because this is a command basic, but this is a BE. For this is common use in the 4 days. Next, the describe to the data GTSPP. The download in the link in the NODC, they publish for some institutes that perform oceanographic studies. One automatic way to download file on the with command the command will be do DAT for the Linux, and which makes direct the LAN from the website where they are hiding files. And that is create the GTSPP quality control and the flagging system. The quality control code of the data is important because this control provides the estimate for obtaining appropriate data which real value, and the most specific codification of the data and specific characteristic of the instrument used. Here, this command for the convert hexadecimal and decimal number, and this in the software here. And the demonstrate to load an ECDF file to OSM data view and display TS. This is picture is a Peruvian SIA. The stage is 1,000 for the station and the crusade. I see the characteristic, the temperature is very hot because the year is the El Niño developed because the condition was very strong. This other picture is all Pacific SIA. This day maybe is because the geographic localization is on the line equatorial. And this day is all Pacific, and the temperature, salinity, and depth. So the year 1908, and the other what is date is the from coast to equator. This is cool. Thank you.
Okay. I'm not going to give you a hard time. But I think a very interesting question. Can you show the last two, the slide to the very last two, the one with the one showing temperature, the vertical scale of the temperature? Okay, can you open it up? Normally the G variable is depth, but you are showing temperature versus temperature, so it's kind of many. The vertical axis. Normally we use a G for the color indicated depth, but this is kind of G versus X, so it's kind of
because it's that in this side and no data in the salinity.
I know that, but I just kind of think in this area. Now, there's nothing wrong with what you did. That's kind of interesting about ODV. That's right. I'm interested. You are perfect. Don't worry. I was telling you this maybe because I have a concern about the labeling. See, this is supposed to be next to here. So we understand that this label is for this color scale. Okay. And it's even confused. You said just say depths. And that's what I mean. Look at the title for this figure, it's called depths. So it's not quite right to me. So this is very, very interesting. The one thing I'd like to hear is you about El Niño. Because I expect that G will show something of the Peru. And this is so which year of this? You said that they are deepened.
What is the thermocline? Yeah.
So what year? Which year?
It's year? The thermocline.
Oh, here. Maybe we can see from here.
The year?
1998.
Yes.
The reason why it's so interesting in Peru is because I was thinking to add additional test by using EOF, which stands for empirical orthogonal function. So right now, as you see, the test is always chromatology. So if the profile greater than 3 or 5 standard deviation, then the most people will flag as bad. But in case of the El Niño or La Niña area time, I think profile will be quite off. And you cannot flag as bad. That should be good data. So I was thinking using the EOF as a potential additional test for climate data set. But no, this is probably another training next time. but not this time. Okay, thank you. Very good.
Thank you.
Okay so any question for anyone or any student? No. Okay, and we have another roughly 30 to 40 minutes this morning. What I'd like to do is to go over what we have learned, or what I have present, or we have present here. And so that will go to my last presentation. Is to give you a kind of summary what we have learned or what we have gave to you this or the last 3 days. So this is, you might give this presentation at the very beginning, say Monday. Now we only need 90 minutes and we're done. Okay, so in section 2, we're talking about open source, we're talking about Linux. So by now, I believe you should be able to do the followings. You should be able to apply the Linux share commands, wget, to download GTPP data, which everybody has demonstrated that you are able to do that. And the reason for going using wget, that's the way you can set the automate procedure. So you don't have to sit in front of your disk and to download GTPP file one by one at a time. So that's the reason why we are using wget. Okay. So this is the wget example. And occasionally, don't try to download the whole GTPP data at one time because you will kill all system. I recall when I came to NODC in 1997, we migrate GTPP from the old system to a Sybase. That time, we provide a web interface, but as you see earlier, the WGI, like, and just open it up, within 2 or 3 days, the system crashed because just too many data trying to download at the same time. So try not to download GTPP at one time. It happened in the past. It's occurred a colleague from China. Download a chunk of China data, the GTPP data. So, okay, I see a spike. No. But that's good. It's good to me.
But the other interesting part is because if you download the GTSPP data today and you go back next week, the same area and same time frame, the data content will have changed.
Yeah. So, I was extremely.
More up to date and better.
Okay, but I was so happy that when someone selected up to June 26, which is yesterday or the day before yesterday, we see still some data. So that's really impressed. Okay. We're talking about using QuantTab to schedule an automated Quant job, and I didn't ask you to give a demo on that one, but you know you had not. So when you return to your institution, you should be able to practice. No, just. Okay, so this is the syntax to use QuantTab to initiate automate procedure. We didn't spend too much time on Perl, which is good, you know, to almost everybody of you. Otherwise, you will get more exercise.
Okay. However, we have not, and I will skip this one. No, if you have not, you can learn Perl script later on. Okay, I skip this one. Okay. Or maybe for the next GTP training course, and we can dedicate one section or one or more, or emphasize how to use the Perl. Okay, I skip this one. Okay, we spend a lot of time on open source R. We are still encourage everyone try to learn. You learn how to download R from this website, and it's very easy to install, and it only take a couple of minutes, maybe less than minutes to install. Okay, using R. So to use R, it's nice to ask an administrator to install. Okay. You don't need the administrative privilege to install R as you did for your Windows system. The same thing. You can install Linux just for your personal use. And the only reason using ask the administrator to install, because by doing that, anybody can use. So anybody use one copy. Even your own copy. So yes, to avoid many, many copy on the same machine. Okay, and this is the command that required to install R on Linux. Okay. To install R package, you just say R uppercase CMD uppercase install uppercase and the name of the package to install. So running R from the Linux command line, it's fairly simple. Just type uppercase R, okay, and then it will pop out window. And to run R command from the file, you interactive mode, you still have to say source. So this is the R prompt. So you bring up R and you go to the R environment, and you always have to type source and followed by the program. The program you want to run here. Okay. Now in the bash mode, that means you run from your system prompt, you already say either R script, R uppercase, script lowercase, or this much wording, and followed by the name of the script. They are slightly different, okay, because the output is the same, but there are additional information coming from the first method using this method. Oh. Okay. So they are slightly different, but result the same. The outputs, the form is slightly different. Okay. On session 5, we're talking about GTPP overview, which Bob did a really good job and gave an overview on GTPP, which you should know that. I don't want to repeat. But check a quick look. GTPP started from 1990, became permanent program in 1996. And in 2001, during JCOM 1, define GTPP as a joint program between JCOM and IODE. Okay, we know that GTPP basically has a GTS system on the top for providing near real-time data. We have the server data center, real-time data center, and the DMO data center. And then we have CMD as a long-term archive, and then we have product center. Okay. Now, in the future, maybe you can join GTPP as a product center for your region. That's one concept I'm pushing for right now, called GTPP Regional Product Center. Right now, we only have JMA, the Japan, is for the Northern Pacific Ocean. But I'd like to have other countries get participate within GTPP program, so you can establish your regional product center for GTPP. The only requirement that I anticipate for being a product center is provide feedback to CMD, so we can fix all database, okay? And this can be listed for the server that's running at US NODC. The same data set, you can access that data set from different four methods. Okay, so we learned that GWI. The drawback for GWI right now is by using the Java applet right now here. But the good thing that this Java app allow you to across ocean boundary on any combination or the whole global world at one time. That's fine. Okay. And next thing I'd like to do is to replace the Java app by another open source called open layer. There's a potential risk for using open source. I'd like to get warning you be ahead of time. For example, everybody using Gmail as open source, right? Gmail account is free and so forth. Okay. What happened if Gmail, your Google company, decide to quit? They say, sorry. Or they say, we start to collect money for using Gmail. Then you will get hired because you don't have leisure to use it open source for free. So that's a potential drawback for using open source. And some people already expressed their concern. Right now, we are for open source. It's good for now, but what happened if the project stop? Nobody provides support for open R. So that's a drawback for being using open source. Okay, there's no guarantee that you will get permanent support for open source. Okay, so we're talking about the GTPP SK format, and the GTPP data is organized in two different sections. The first section is a station record, and the second section is a profile record. Okay, that gave you a quick overview about GTPP ASCII format. We are working on to stop using GTPP ASCII format because they are limited. You can count by line or by each position. So a lot of features we like to add into the CMD and add into the ASCII format, we cannot do it because the limitation on the width of each column. So we are moving from ASCII format to NetCDF for either exchange among the partners or serving that format for data distribution. So right now we are serving GTPP data in three formats, as you know, the ASCII, NetCDF, and spreadsheet format. Okay, this is a Perl script, and we try a couple of them during the course to convert GTPP ASCII to text format. You can use GTPP to text.perl. Okay, with the very end option say text here, or you can convert from ASCII to comma separate value CSV. By adding option this CSV, so you know this here for your information only. Okay, now or you can use an R to read ASCII, and the way program to read is a GTPP to ODB, which everybody should be very familiar with that. Now, number seven, section seven, we talk about the NetCDF format description. Okay, we briefly talk about that. Okay, so NetCDF stands for Network, Data Form. It's the interface for array, oriented data set. I like to remind everyone, NetCDF convention is array focused. It even if it's a one single value, you should treat that value as array, not just a constant. Okay. GTPP using the classical mode, which means the NetCDF version 3 only. Okay, you learned how to use NC dump to display either the entire data or just display the header information by doing NC dump dash C or NC dump dash H, and you are be able to convert NCDF into different format, either CDL, which stands for comma data language, or convert into XML. Okay, NC dump dash, this should be X, not this. I said this is a typo. Should be X, not K. Okay, this is the procedure how to read NCDF file. You load NCDF4 package first. Now you assign the file name, then you use the NC underscore open to open it. And this is the following just a way to display the numbers of dimensions of variables or global attributes and then so forth. Okay. The number eight. We're talking about GTPP call table. So, and this is the listing. And then we keep this web page updated on a daily basis. Okay. Session number nine. You know, Bob spent a lot of time talking about GTPP data QC procedures. And this is the point that GTPP never ever change data. Okay, unless it is necessary to make change. and we preserve original data in a separate table. Okay. So talking about a quality-flex system, it's GTPP. We use in two levels, level one and level two. So I don't have to, we don't, it looks like you, everybody catch what we talk, so understand that pretty well. That's good. So we try this couple times. Interpret QC the procedure, that either test or code result. Okay, which should be straightforward. We're talking about the QC tagging system. So basically, we are using CRC. And it's very important to remove the duplicate. Otherwise, you know, when you calculate heat content, you don't want to double counting the heat content. Otherwise, the global ocean is warmer than what you expect. So remove, identify the unique tag, and remove the duplicate is very important in terms of scientific study of the ocean climate system. Okay. So in GTSPP using CRC, okay, this is go through very quick about what's the definition of CRC. Okay, and then we talk about XBT data management system. Okay, there will be a XBT workshop in Beijing near the November this year. Yeah, hopefully they can come out with a standard. A quality standard method for depth correction. Okay. So in GTSPP, we developed a logic for depth correction, but we didn't make any correction on the data only. We only make suggestions using the vector, you know, which is 1.036. Okay. And there's always a way to identify the type of XBT pro information, and we make effort to identify it. Not all of them, but most of them, to tell users say this pro need to be correct or not correct at all. And as I said, that's a very simple suggestion on GTPP by using 1.0336. Okay, and this is the table showing what the meaning of DPG dollar sign. One means this is the pro. We know the pro type that need correction. Okay, and then that 02, no need to make correction and so forth. Okay. And then we learn how to use it. We didn't spend too much time to tell you how to write code to display only the data you're interested in. Okay. And by doing this, actually you have more control, to display the data or to analyze the data the way you like to see. But using ODV, which is good, but you are limited what ODV provide to you. Okay. Now, because of time limit, we didn't spend too much time to telling you how to use an R to visualize or analyze the GTPP data. Okay. Now, we talk about the NC browse, which is another way to get a quick look on NetCDF data. Okay. And we learn, everybody learn how to install. Number one, I did talk to IT fork, during the coffee break, I said, we save a lot of his time to install ODV on each individual machine. He was quite happy that we did that. Okay. So I don't have to repeat the ODV again. This is kind of give you a quick refresh your memory. So we know how to load data into ODV, right? So everybody already should know that so far. So that's all what I have to say and quick. It's more than only 20 minutes. So thank you again for coming to this course, and I do appreciate your feedback. So this is the end. I leave my email address on the whiteboard. So if any question you have when you return to your institution, just email me and I try to find answer for you. Okay, and thank you, Bob. Thank you, Claudia, for organizing the training. It's a great experience to share with you on GTSPP, and I learned a lot from everybody of you. Yeah, so, okay, thank you for coming. Any question? So, okay, Jimmy.
Actually, the question we know lectures, but I would appreciate if I could leave her on Linux. I tried doing some downloads over the night, throughout the night, but instead it became on, it's downloaded on .iso, which means maybe I have to get a CD to burn it and all this stuff. But I wouldn't know if it's going to work, because for us to really appreciate the, you know, I tried downloading the copy that to install on my system, but it's not working. So if I could lay hand on the Linux and install it and see this thing working, it would be easier to do it back home. But when you get back home, there's so many challenges there that you end up.
You mean the system at NLD is not working?
No.
Or the system here? Your PC not working?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what kind of system you are using? Is it PC? Yeah. Okay. No, I think this will be, you will stay here a little bit longer. No, I'm joking. But no, yeah, maybe, you know. Maybe we can talk a little bit. No, you like, you know, I can try to understand. We are in person to understand what's your problem. I'd really like to help you to solve your problem. Okay.